Hey guys, hope you're having a great day. Those are great life.
Dude, great life.
Oh yeah.
Doing some Frank Zappa.
Inca Rhodes.
So, I mean, we've seen him everywhere in the comments. I've heard of his name a bunch just come up through conversations with people. I've heard he's super prolific. So,
total like composer of like music is what I've heard from you guys and others.
Yeah, so I mean, with that, we're really excited. We have heard none of him, so I don't really quite know what to expect. That being said, before we start, you guys have been asking for it. So on Instagram, we're actually posting our favorite reaction, our top pick from next week's songs on Instagram. So you get to know what's coming up before anyone else does. Check the description if you want that link, but we'll be posting it there. That being said,
let's go and dive into
it. Great drumming. Baseline is it's almost like a motif. Wrong word. It's really cool. It's so catchy. We'll be right back.
dead of the hickle bomb. I'm somewhere around the dead of the hickle bomb. I'm somewhere around the dead. The Indians were on the bell, carve up the hill.
That was avant-garde for sure. Very jazzy.
So out there in such a different way than what we've heard previously.
It's true. Funny enough, I do listen to some modern jazz. So yeah. Some bigger ones like Snarky Puppies. There's an Israeli jazz group called the Vassai Cohen Trio who are phenomenal. They're like my go-to study music. So for anybody needing to study, like, it literally is my, I go to it, like, this album, Gently Disturbed, every single time. That's what I do if I'm, like, needing to get in the zone and do crazy math equations. Like, that's it. And
true stuff.
Listening to him felt very much like he was a forefather to a lot of that sort of stuff. That very, like, the modern jazz scene, it seems like, was very much influenced by, if not this song in particular, at least him
his style and, like, things that he's done.
Yeah. or even Jacob Collier. Some of the vocals stylings in it sounded a lot like him. So these are just some like modern people that I can relate back to him as like people who clearly took inspiration. Even Kendrick Lamar, that the he had a, so these are all sort of not in the rock realm, but he had a really big record around like I think like 2016 called To Pimp a Butterfly that seems like it borrowed heavily from this, like everything from the guitar tone to like some of the bass stuff, the rhythm tracks. Yeah, I thought it was really, really awesome. This is a really awesome track.
That shit was crazy, dude.
Yeah.
It, like, there was a point where I wasn't even trying to bob or get in the groove. I was kind of just like sitting there and like letting it have its way with me, you know. Yeah. It was awesome though. Like it took me on so many different paths that I didn't expect to go. Like it had me down like balls deep in one path, and then out of nowhere it pulls you out with some like just funky moment, and then it kind of throws you down another path, and all these different just layering elements that they utilize to craft these different paths were just crazy. And the rhythm section itself, just dude, the bassist and the drummer alone were
insane,
dude. Literally just like crafted the path, the foundation.
I had read in the comments that he's like considered like, or maybe you said it, it was like one of the last really great composers, I guess, in this sort of field. And that's exactly what it felt like. It felt like compositional work. So I don't know if Frank Zappa played in the band itself.
I think I read that he did guitar work. Like, I think he was the guitarist in this, but don't quote me. I'm sure they'll let us know at this point.
Either way, it seemed like he either had maybe like a rotation of different players, like different drummers, different bass players, singers, or...
like session musicians and stuff?
It sounds like session musicians. It sounds like people that you called like a... it seems like you called like some fucking crazy jazz players... and you were like, here is the music that I wrote. Back me up in this. So I don't know if he had like a long-term, like, hey, this is actually just my band. Or my my first thought is that he just was like, I'm a great composer. I'm going to call you guys to like hear a bunch of friends that I've worked with in the past or people I know that are great. Like, come do this with me.
Yeah. So, definitely comment below and let us know, like, what is Frank Zappa? What is his deal? Like, explain.
I think we're both a little awestruck by it. It's not a song that meets you halfway. Like this requires you to put on a lot of work to appreciate it.
Everything that he's doing. One of the things I was thinking through the song at multiple points was this song needs a good like 9 to 20 listens.
Yeah,
just in general, so that like you can attempt to expect what's coming next, so that you're ready for it. The turn that he's gonna take you on.
Yeah.
It wasn't a bad thing. It was just like,
no, it's just there are some bands and some songs that like I think Born in the Bayou, right?
Mm-hmm.
Weird to relate these two songs because they're not really
polar
opposites in the way of Born in the Bayou is a song that really
it
does all the work for you, and it's not a bad thing. It's like that's super necessary sometimes and super what you want. This is a song that's the total opposite, where it's like, hey, listen, we did some fucking crazy art here. If you want to appreciate it, you're going to have to put in as much effort as we put in to make it.
Like, at least we're not going to... a good fraction.
Like, we're not going to hold your hand to do this. You're going to have to, like, dive in, like, face first, like, go into it. Rating.
I don't know yet. I'm still talking, dude. I have a lot to say.
All right, what are you going to say?
Dude, I loved the breakdown region that happened around, I want to say, not the halfway point, but, like, the 42% mark-ish. Where it kind of settled down, everything pulled back, and then the guitar came in.
Yeah.
Super creamy, super just smooth tone at first. And then he totally just like...
the wah effect.
Oh, yeah. Developed his own, like his style. Because he came across like he was going to be playing a certain way. And just the note choice and the tonality of it, he made it appear as though he was going to continue playing that way, you know? And then as it progressed and developed, he like built upon his own like ideas and just kept building it up. I just feel like this inspired so many just like different feelings. You know, like if you don't like overanalyze too much and kind of just like sit back and listen to it, like just the note choices and the tonalities and the, like the rhythms themselves kind of like just make you feel certain feelings at different points in the song. Definitely cool song. Okay. What's your rating?
What's my rating?
Yeah.
Bring the question back. I think Oh, we're doing the new grading system.
Oh, grading. Okay.
Grading system. All right, that makes it a little easier. I think this is an A-tier song.
A-tier?
I think so. I don't know. Like, it is very different. Is it my favorite song we've done on the channel? No. Is it one that I really respect for what it is? Like, I mean, this is obviously a very progressive, jazz-inspired track. And it's pushing boundaries in a lot of ways that are... like non-conforming to the normal sensibilities of what was going on then.
Like, and that doesn't go on the radio, really.
No.
I mean, I'm sure somebody aired it, but not like a
maybe.
Lot. You know maybe. What I'm saying?
That's tough for the most of people. If you hear that out of nowhere, you're going to be like, I don't know if I want that. In fact, I'm pretty sure I don't.
Yeah, most
but if
people.
You're seeking out that sort of thing, I thought it was really cool. So as a fan of, again, and these are just modern artists that I like that did a similar style of this, like Snarky Puppies or the Kendrick Lamar album, that have this sort of element to them, I think it's really, really good.
I'm going to give it A tier as well. I want to give it S tier, but like maybe over many listens I'll change, but there were certain moments where I was feeling a certain mood, and it's okay to pull me out of the sauce. It's okay to go, okay, you've had enough of this sauce, I'm going to put you in this sauce. But sometimes the way they dragged me into the other sauce was a little, not like abrupt.
Chaotic, maybe?
Yes. Like some of the vocal things, I don't want to, cheesy is not the right word, but like it relative to the intense depth and just all everything that's happening with certain sections, and then you kind of you pull back with some like in your face vocal work. I'm kind of like, okay, like I was swimming in the sauce, you know, if that makes sense. So that's the reason I'm gonna give it A tier, but I'm 100% positive that he has S tier work of the same like style.
Yeah,
I guess.
Yeah, I also,
I don't know if that makes any sense, guys.
I also think A-tier, we haven't been exposed to enough of this stylistic.
Yeah, I think I don't have the credentials to like put this in a tier, but I'll say A tier anyway.
Yeah. You know what I mean? Yeah, anyways, great song. Let us know if we should do more of him, if we should, what songs we should do next, if that's the case, and what your thoughts were. This is a really weird track.
So yeah, I'm sure not all of you guys have heard of this. I'm sure like some of you have, but I'm sure there's plenty of ANA people here who like, oh, ANA posted a new video, let's watch the video. And it's like, they haven't heard it, but it's like, yeah, so let us know your thoughts as well.
Yeah, so comment down below. We'll be down there reading them, because this is one that I really am interested to see what the general populace thinks of this sort of stuff. Boom. That being said, we'll see you in the next video.